Good morning. It is Hannah from Communication Wise, and today I want to talk about the question why. So I was just on Facebook, and then I was not exactly scrolling, but the first Facebook friend with her post came up, and she was asking, why are people against wearing masks? Because I think she is for wearing masks and a lot of people are against wearing masks. And so I think it is a good question. Why are you against or why are you for? And so unfortunately, I do not have the answer. And also, I don't really have an opinion because I don't know how to form my opinion. I think this is all very new to us and we're all just, you know, trying to figure things out in the current situation. I do have one, you know, source of information, and that is my dad. He is a medical doctor and he has worked his whole life for the government. Really, figuring out, you know, how, like, what does the, what do influ, like, viruses and pandemics do to, like, how do you deal with that as a government, you know, public health, all those things. And then you would think he had, you know, some ideas, and he doesn't, you know, he is way too deep in it to have, you know, like one clear answer, you know, those quotes or like one-liners don't really go in this really important question. So yeah, as long as we don't have answers, like we can ask the question why, and I don't think it is a bad question. I think it is a good question. I just don't think there is an answer just because this is all new to us. What I want to talk about is mediation. So mediation is a process where there are two parties, usually two parties, and they have a conflict. And so it could be about anything. When, you know, two persons are in conflict with each other, and they do want to work it out, they do want some sort of solution, they can, you know, go to court, but then they give it out of hands, you know, a judge is going to decide, but they can also go to mediation and try to work it out. So I'm going to give you an example of a mediation that I did, and it made me really think about the question, why do we want to know what is beyond, you know, the positions that people walk into a conflict with. Why do we ask why? So my example was a mediation with four older ladies, and they had to make a decision about their mother's estate. The mother had passed away. She had left a will. There was an estate attorney, and he had sat down with the ladies, and he just, you know, had no idea what to do with them. So he sent them to me to try to, like, work it out with me. So this is back in the Netherlands. I was sitting in my office, and, you know, these four older ladies walk in, very nice, they seem to be very easygoing. They actually seem to be more excited. You know, they had that excitement over them as if they were, you know, going on a field trip instead of entering a difficult conversation. But they were very friendly. And you know, it's in the Netherlands, it's common to, you know, offer somebody a cup of tea or coffee. So we all had tea, we sat down, exchanged some pleasantries, and there we started. So, of course, you know, like, this is, not an easy thing to talk about, but we had to start somewhere. So I was like, so tell me why you're here, you know, what is the reason that you're here? So the older sister explained that, you know, the mother had passed away and that there was a will that they had to divide the assets of the mother. And basically it was a large sum of money after the mother's house would be sold. So the mother's will had given them instructions though, and it basically said that the younger sister was able to, you know, allowed to stay in the house as long as she wanted, because the younger sister had lived with the mother, and that she, you know, would have, that in the will it said, like, you can live off of my possessions as long as you basically want. So the other sisters weren't so happy about that. And so they were very upset about this, you know, sort of will that that decided that they weren't gonna get anything. And so the older sisters were considering legal actions against the younger sister and against, you know, the will. All the ladies in my room seemed to be well off. They didn't seem to really like need the money, and you can't like assume this, but from, you know, like there's a couple basic needs that we all need, but, money, like financial security didn't seem one of them, or economic well-being didn't seem to make sense. So, they were fundamentally divided about the issue though. It was very, very deep to them. And so if you don't need the money, but this is something that you care a lot about, then there's something else going on. And they weren't really telling me. And so I started asking questions like, so how would another way of dividing the assets meet your needs? How is the current division impacting you? Why do you care? And and this is in a curious way. This is not like, why would you care? This is really like, what makes you feel the way you feel about this subject? And this is about money, but it isn't about money, because money is not what you need. So what is it? And so they were talking about fairness a lot. So I asked, like, what does mean fair to you? What is fairness? And, explain to me what you mean when you say fair. So this was very interesting, because now it's not about like a pie and dividing the pie. It really is like, what is beyond there, right? So after a lot of questions and circling around a couple subjects and a lot of rephrasing, so that, you know, the one sister who was benefited from this all could actually hear what the other sisters were saying and vice versa, it turned out that the three older sisters had felt unloved and uncared for by their mother when she was still alive. They felt that the younger sister was getting everything and had been getting everything during the mother's life. And so these are needs, you know, that like that yearning for love, that is a need. But it is not something that you can negotiate, like the mother had passed. So that's a no-go. And now these emotions are obviously not solvable in whatever setting, not even in a mediation, even though I say mediation is great, but like that is not doable. So really they didn't work it out in like that. There was no agreement at the end of this mediation, but it was still very valuable. And this is why I'm giving this example. Because, you know, by like hashing out the issue, by like going deep into, the underlying interest, it did give them a lot of clarity, and it did give them a lot of understanding, not even so much about the other, but about themselves. This is why I can't live with this, you know, will, or like, I can't live with this dividing the assets just because this is what I need and I don't get that. And so now it's going to be an issue of letting go, because the love, the care from your mother who has passed away is something that you will never get, right, in this lifetime. So the ability of letting go of those needs may take a little bit of time, honestly. And so when they walked away, it was time for patience, and it was time for other things than, you know, working on settling the estate. So I'm telling you all this because it explains why we look for interests in mediation rather than negotiating based on positions. I mean, I have sat with numerous custody mediations where the mother has said, like, I want full custody of the children. He like, I don't need him. I don't want him. I don't want any, like, and the kids don't either. And so I'm asking her questions like, okay, so what, like, where is this coming from? Well, he's not there anyways. Okay, so give me an example for when he wasn't there. And then, you know, when you go deeper, it turns out that, and not always, but like in some cases, it turns out that the mother does want the assistance. She does want that for the other parent to take responsibility and, you know, care for them, like in a financial or like in like a literally caring for them way. So this is very interesting, because when you get to the needs, when you get to something very basic and you peel off all those layers of positions, this is what I want, this is what I don't want, okay, tell me why. Because when you get there and you create more understanding, this is where that person is coming from, this is where that person is coming from, there are going to be a lot more options and opportunity to work things out. So unfortunately, I don't have solutions for the mask situation. I do not have solutions for the whole, you know, getting over the pandemic situation, but I do understand, and I would actually promote, when you are dealing with another person and you do not agree with them, that is fine, but just be a little curious. And if you really want to work it out or like get more understanding, we just have to ask why, you know, what is under their position. So I'm hoping this was helpful. I'll be back maybe this week, maybe next week, and I will put whatever I just said, I will put it in a blog, and I'm going to post it or publish it on my website, which is communicationwise.org. And I can also, you know, put a link on the Facebook or Instagram, Communication Wise, so you can read it over if you want to. And for now, thank you so much for watching. Bye.